Welcome back to the channel guys, and in today's video we are going to feature a very strong Zeru team, and this is the team which I made just today and have been getting really positive matches with it. So this team in my opinion is really really strong and has a lot of coverages as well, and the battles which we are going to see is 10 and 0 set, and out of these I think I lost leads quite a bit. So I am going to show the set that I lost leads first and then the other set with a 5 and so if you are new to the channel and if you like our content, don't forget to hit the like and subscribe button, and if you are already subscribed to the channel, a big thanks to all of you. Also, if you want to join the Battleset Discord server, the link to that is in the description down below. So without further delays, let's start with the battles and see how the battle goes. So picking up a positive lead in the form of this drill burr, it's not drill burr but excadrill. So the opponent is staying in surprisingly, maybe they don't know the matchup yet, and since Zerud is recently released, I don't think a lot of players are familiar with the matchups. As you can see, they went for a drill run which is resisted because of grass typing on Zerud, and this is what makes this Pokemon really good against the meta, because something like Groudon, Kyogre is weak to the grass types, and something like Mewtwo, Giratina are weak to dark types. So it has a lot of good coverages as well. And the opponent is staying in this matchup, which is fine with me. And they double shield as well, which is a positive matchup for Zerud. I do need to shield this one, but I will be able to outpace but we will be able to outpace this Excadrill to the next charge move, and we'll be able to throw this Power Whip, which will be able to knock them out. Let's see what they decide to bring this in. I'm expecting a Dialga in the back, which you can see, because Excadrill is weak to the something like Kyogre or Giratina's, and Dialga is very strong up against those. So yeah, and they throw a charge move, which is still fine with me, and surprisingly they go for a Thunder. Not really sure why they did that, and they quit. So maybe they were running double steel in the back. So yeah, good games. Moving on to the next one, picking up a negative lead this time and swapping into Lugia, which is my safe swap, and they come in with Garchomp and the Dragon Tail Garchomp as well, so I can surely flip this matchup around if I manage to shield the Outrage. So since they did not charge up to the Outrage, there was no point in me shielding this. That was definitely a Sand Tomb. It takes 5 Dragon Tails to get to a Sand Tomb, 7 to an Earth Power, and I think 8 to an Outrage. So yeah, no need to shield this one. Or is it 6 to an Earth Power and 7 to an Outrage? Not really comfortable with the Garchomp Dragon Tail matchups anymore. So yeah, in comes this this Togekiss, which is neat for me because I have been able to I am able to flip the switch advantage. That would mean I will be able to pair Excadrill up against the Togekiss, and with a shield advantage, I think this game is pretty much over. And I am totally expecting them to have something weak to Zerud in the back, since they had two Pokemon which were relatively strong, and in comes this thing. So this game is pretty much over at this point of time, because all Groudon can throw at us it's the fire punches, and they would need 3 fire punch in order to knock Zerud out, and we will be able to outpace them to at least three fire punches. We will be able to throw this next Power Whip, and since we are still switch locked, they will not be able to make the swap into their Pokemon. And let's see, yes, we will have to eventually shield, but now we will be able to throw this Power Whip in order to knock out the Groudon, and it was a CMP type which Zerud apparently loses. So this is not a good IV Zerud. As you can see, it's 10, 10, 12, and now I make an immediate swap to my Excadrill, which will be able to knock out their Togekiss. So yeah, this is a GG. So irrespective of losing the lead, I think Lugia safe swap is terrific, and losing the lead yet again, and now again I'll make a swap to my Lugia, and my opponent is surprisingly staying in there, not swapping out, which is good for me, or you can say it's bad for me as well, because that way this Dialga gets to avoid my Excadrill, and primary use for Excadrill is up against those Dialgas only, and this indicates me that they have something weak to Lugia in the back. Maybe they're running Kyogre, and probably that's why. And they let go of the Aeroblast, which is quite good, because I can safely no shield this one. If it's a Draco, it will KO, But it's just an iron head, and we will be able to completely farm down their Dialga. So with Dialga out of the picture, unless they have another dragon, the Zarud will be able to any dragon besides Giratina. I think Zarud will be able to handle that Giratina pretty well. So now they make a swap into their Mewtwo. And I definitely can pressure a shield at least up against this Mew, and this shield straight away, which is fine with me, because now they will have to throw a flamethrower or a focus blast in order to knock us out, and they go for a focus blast, which is fine with me because now they will have to throw another focus blast in order to knock us out, and this will come down to the bait game, because if they manage to bait us with a psi strike and then go for a focus blast, it's pretty much game over for me. And that's why I go for a no shield. As you can see, I thought about it a lot, and it ends up being a psi strike, so I was able to make a call, and they swapped too early, and I wasn't anyway going to throw it on the right when I got the move, because I was expecting a catch, and now I just need to farm up to two power whips. So this power whip will be going up against this Kyogre, which will be able to knock them out, and this Dark Pulse, I would need to shield this charge move. I think even Psy Strike will KO us, especially since we are not running a good IV Zarude, and this Dark Pulse surely will be able to knock out the Mewtwo. I think it does around 60 to 70% of Mewtwo's health, so that range was pretty much comfortable to knock them out. So yeah, good games. Moving on to the next one, picking up yet another bad lead, and now again Lugia saves swap, and in comes Excadrill, so losing the swap here as well, but the good thing about Zarud is that it will be able to completely farm down this this Excadrill by the time this Lugia gets by the time Lugia gets done with this Excadrill. So we are going for this Aeroblast, and Excadrill will need to respect the damage coming in from it. So I am very positive that Lugia can definitely survive can survive this Rock Slide, and they will need to throw another Rock Slide in order to knock us out. And since I'm very close to an Aeroblast, I decide to shield, because this way I will be either grabbing the last shield or will be able to win the switch advantage. I am definitely expecting a steel type in the back. Maybe it's a Melmetal or a Dialga. So at this point, I'm comfortable of letting go of Lugia, because I can safely come in with Zarud, and will have to completely farm them down, because Excadrill will need two Rock Slides in order to knock out the Dragonite there, and this Dark Pulse and this Energy Farm will really help in knocking out the Dragonite. We can take two Rock Slides, but we are able to completely farm down the Excadrill, which is pretty good, because this Dark Pulse will be able to bring this Dragonite to yellow, and now I'll make a immediate swap to Excadrill. So I am expecting a catch, to be honest, and they try to go for a catch and they swap into Mewtwo, but Excadrill is so loaded on energy, it will be able to beat Mewtwo to even at a side strike. So we will be throwing this immediately, because I don't want to take any damage from side strike, even because side strike does a lot even though it's resisted. And now the game is pretty much wrapped up, and the opponent realizes, and yeah, good games. Moving on to the next one, picking up a positive lead finally, and they are staying in this matchup surprisingly. Maybe they want to throw a Dragon Claw and Bale, and potentially even catch a Dark Pulse onto a Fairy type if they are running one. So yeah, they are going for a Dragon Claw. So I go for a Dark Pulse, and this Dark Pulse will do some decent damage. I think it does 50 to 60%. Yeah, it does roughly about 50%. And in comes Dialga. So this is probably the perfect match that Excadrill could have been in. So as you can see, this Excadrill is not 15 attacks, so it does slightly less damage, but I am actually okay with this, because this allows Excadrill to farm a lot of energy off this Dialga, and we have a lot of energy. I think one drill run plus one mud shot. So in comes Kyogre, which is perfect for me, because now we have the perfect alignment. What was the lead? Yeah, they had a Giratina altered in the lead, so I will be able to pair Giratina up against the Lugia and Zarude up against the Kyogre. and we are at a power whip, which I throw immediately. I could have farmed some extra energy, but I really wanted to get rid of this Kyogre as soon as I can. And they would need to land a Blizzard in order to knock us out. The Surf will not be able to KO. And let's see. So opponent goes for Blizzard, which was the right play in my opinion. Otherwise, they would have to throw two Surfs regardless. So at this stage, I am looking to completely farm down this. This Kyogre, and Kyogre goes for a Surf. That was definitely not a Blizzard. I was counting the fast moves, and they go for this charge move. At this point, the game is pretty much wrapped up. I will do a BM to my opponent by going for the Aeroblast, but I think Psy Strike and one Dragon Tail would have been enough to knock out the Giratina. But yeah, this is game over. So GG's. So this is a set where I went 5-0. So starting off with an exit, and this is where things get tricky, because I just wanted to get rid of this game because my opponent lagged a lot in this particular one, and eventually they'll quit the game. So yeah, I think Lugia had a lot of energy, so they quit eventually. Yeah, sorry for my opponent that the game lagged. But yeah, it happens to everyone. So quickly moving on to the next one, picking up a positive lead in the form of this Giratina. Getting a weak connection, never good to see. So Groudon. So Groudon will be going for those fire punches here and there. And as I said, Groudon will need to throw three fire punches, and they make a swap to Dialga. And at this point, I was really frustrated because the game started lagging. And I didn't know if the Dialga got any energy or not, but I have lost count now, so we definitely would need to be very cautious about this. And Dialga shields, which is good for me, because I definitely would want to respect a Draco. So they go for a Draco Meteor, which is fine since I shielded that. And now I'll do an undercharge, a slight undercharge. As you can see, I just went for a Great, because this will allow me to get some additional farm on the Excadrill. And since they went for a Draco, they would not have gotten to another one. So Groudon will have to take at least one Drill Run, and if they do not decide to throw, or I make a very good combo play here by going for this Power Whip, this will either grab the last shield or will knock out the Groudon. Groudon shields, which is good for me, and they have a Zacian in the back, and this is probably good for me because they will have to throw a close combat or a play rough in order to knock us out. And if they go for a close combat, they will have to lower their defense, which is perfect for my Lugia in the back. And Groudon is just a pile of waste because it cannot do anything to Lugia. And now I make come in with Excadrill because I want them to throw their charge move, and going for a shield because maybe I wanted to get rid of the Zacian with Excadrill. But the game is pretty much wrapped up. Maybe I was just trying to delay that, or just to be sure, I wanted them to throw a close combat because Zacian technically can have a wild charge. So yeah, good games to my opponent. Moving on to the next one and picking up a positive lead, and now they make a swap to Dialga. I love Dialga swap-ins with this team. Like, our opponent can swap in their Dialga here and there, and day and night, I will be pretty much happy with it. So Dialga does not shield, and as you can see, you definitely would want to shield, but in my opinion, it's a worthy shield. Even if they go for an Iron Head, it's a Draco, so that was a good shield regardless. But because you get so much energy in this matchup, I think even if you get baited, it's totally worth it. So in comes their own Zarud, and as you can see, I think this is the game where I noticed Zarud's CP, and they are rocking a 3771. Yeah, they have 3771, and I am just on 3695 something, and I managed to catch a power whip onto Zarud of my own, which is good for me. But the game is still not over because they have a very healthy Mewtwo in the back, and possibly they are saving two shields for Mewtwo, and it is the case. They are saving two shields for Mewtwo, and this is where I will get to know that whether Mewtwo is running Focus Blast, what is the second charge move on the Mewtwo if it's a Shadow Ball, Ice Beam, Flamethrower, or a Focus Blast, because this will really help in deciding me what my strategy up against when I'm playing with Lugia. So they go for a Focus Blast, and this is pretty much game over because Lugia will be able to completely wall this thing off. And again, I'm trying to BM my opponent at this stage. Before today, I lost like 10-0. So I deserve a slight I deserve some BM when I can. So GG's. Moving on to the next one, and we are in a Zarud mirror match, and I am most likely to lose to Zarud because of the CM, especially because of the CMP, and I don't want to swap into either of my Pokemon. I wanted to get rid of this thing as soon as I can, and if they go for switch advantage, I let them be and come in with Lugia and farm down. Surprisingly, they make a swap into Zacian, and I try to catch a close combat there, but that did not happen. And if they're running wild charge and player of if they're running wild charge, it's going to be bad. So they are rocking wild charge, but they lower their defense by two stages, which is good, because now this is the right time to throw a sky attack. They will be shielding this one. It's good for me because now I can return the favor by shielding the charge move, or I let go of Lugia. That's probably the right play, because I can farm some extra energy off Zarud and still keep my two shields. So they shield Zacian surprisingly, and I can safely shield this move, but I will have to throw a move right away, because I don't want this Zacian to get away, because if they would have gotten away, would have been problem for my Excadrill in the back. And they come in with Zarud, and this makes me think that they have something weak to Zarud in the back. Maybe something like a Giratina, and that's why probably you'll see me swapping into Excadrill at some point of time. So they go for a Dark Pulse, which I'm not sure which is the correct move in this particular situation. If it's Dark Pulse or a Power Whip, I'm going for a Power Whip. There is a big energy difference, and now I swapped into Excadrill because I wanted to bait out their Pokemon. And it's a as of now I just noticed a Dragon Tail. So if it's a Garchomp, so they have a Lugia in the back, and fortunately I threw a Rock Slide, so this is good for me. I just need to make sure that I don't allow them to get to a Rock Slide, sorry, not a Rock Slide, but Aeroblast, because if they get to an Aeroblast, it's game over for me. So that's why I was counting the fast moves, and right before they get to Aeroblast, I throw this charge move. And now I make a swap to Zarud of my own, and this Zarud, this is basically curtains down for my opponent. So yeah, we will have to see Zarud's devilish eyes for a moment, because probably my opponent left. And so Zarud pulling off the weight in the last one, but yeah, good games. Moving on to the next one, picking up a negative lead again, and safe swapping into my Lugia, and the opponent is staying in. Surprisingly, maybe they have a Kyogre in the back. I mean, it's very common to have a Kyogre, and my opponent makes a very very confusing play by coming in with Groudon at this stage, because this team is very difficult for Groudon, and I get an attack boost as well, and with Groudon I don't need to shield anything. I can I simply can farm this thing down, to be honest. And this is basically game over. If they have a Kyogre in the back, it's even better. Kyogre, Giratina, it's especially better for my team. So I'll shield this one, especially with the attack boost. It's going to be in our favor, and they will definitely would want to shield. As you can see, even the Dragon Tails are adding up now, so they will have to definitely shield this one. And if they decide to shield, I think I will be able to get to another sky attack. Able to get to another sky attack, and this sky attack will be able to knock out their Dialga, and they are keeping one shield, and they have a Mewtwo in the back. And I make a swap to Zarud. I want to see what the charge move they have, and I think at this point of time I wanted to catch a Psy Strike, which I am able to do, so that is pretty good. And my opponent surrenders. Picking off a 10-0 win of this team, and I really really feel like this team is really strong. So you can run this team, and if you do run this team, do let me know in the comment section down below how your sets went with it. And if you enjoyed watching this video and these battles, don't forget to hit the like and subscribe button. Until next time, peace.